It's Walt, 101 WKQX, backstage at Riot Fest with Rivers Cuomo from Weezer. How's it going?
Very well, thanks.
Fantastic. So tonight you're doing the Blue album in its entirety. How many times have you done that?
Well, that used to be the only album we had, so we played it every night.
Touche.
Hundreds and hundreds of times, probably.
Recently?
We haven't been playing it recently because we have a new album coming out. We're focused on that.
Gotcha. Speaking of the new record, working again with Rick Ocasek, you guys seem to have a bit of a chemistry when you guys do records together because they always turn out some hits.
Yeah, he's definitely a part of what Weezer is. He's a part of that sound. He was there with us when we made our first record. It's actually his guitar that I use when I'm recording, and it's just something about his energy. We all, I think because he was such a megastar when we were growing up, that when as soon as he walks in the room, we all just feel a lot humbler and we try harder, and that's how we get that sound.
Well, and you can hear it, I think, on the current single, Back to the Shack. It's got that sound like it could have been straight from the Blue album, but yet contemporary for today.
Yeah, this actually, if you break it down, there's a lot of elements that have nothing to do with how we sounded in 94. It's much much more of a hard rock type of riff and a more groovy drum pattern. But once again, you get us in a room with Rick and it just ends up sounding like Weezer.
Yeah, you get that little keyboard riff in there that kind of throws it back, at least for me, to the Blue album.
Yeah.
So what is Back to the Shack about? I mean, it obviously harkens back to the old days.
Yeah, for me it's just coming back to the small core community of Weezer and its audience, its fans. When we were starting out playing in the clubs every week, we were surrounded by our audience and we kind of figured out who we were and what we wanted to do in a collaborative process with that audience. And over the years, it's easy to get separated from the audience and you just start working like you're in a bunker on your own, or even worse, you have advisors around you who weren't there in the early days with the best of intentions. They can lead you astray. And even especially with the internet, you don't want to play your new songs while you're still figuring them out, because as soon as you do, they're going to get shared around the world and judged as if they were finished products. So it wasn't until I think 2011 when we went on the Weezer cruise with a few thousand of the most hardcore fans, and we were locked up with them without without any internet for 5 days, and it was just so great to feel that that live human energy and see how much they loved us and how they wanted the best for us and wanted us to, they loved us for who we were.
All right.
And so it was real inspiring, and ever since then we've made a point to meet with fans after the shows and play them songs and see what's going on in their lives and share what's going on in ours, and together we've come up with this new record.
That's fantastic. I think it's so important to have that connection with your audience.
Yeah, that's how we got off the ground in the first place, so it's really good to be with him again.
I never thought about that, being on the being on a cruise and then you're completely locked away from the internet, being able to just focus on what everybody loves, and that on a Weezer cruise is you guys. That's great.
Yeah, it's everyone goes through withdrawal, but it turns out to be a great
after
thing.
The first 24 hours everybody's good to go. So 10 bands here at Riot Fest are playing essential records or seminal records in their collection, like you guys doing the Blue album. What would be an essential record in your collection, in your life?
Probably a whole record. Maybe Nevermind.
Yeah.
Nirvana. Yep, they were the ones.
I mean, that really broke down the door for so many people at it when that came down. I mean, that was such a turning point, I think, for alternative music in general.
Yeah, it was, you know, you can just be yourself and even if you're grungy or you don't look like a typical celebrity, and as long as you have passion and you work hard, you can find an audience. And I think that was super inspiring for most of the musicians in my generation.
Fantastic. I'm looking so forward to hearing the new record, which comes out in a few weeks on October 7th. Any insight as to what the rest of it sounds like?
Well, let's see. We got Back to the Shack and Cleopatra available on iTunes now.
Right.
And I think Lonely Girl comes out tomorrow or the next day on Samsung phones as a free download if you want it. And then those who've signed up for the pre-order on our pledge page are going to get a song called The British Are Coming. And these are all like, they sound like classic Weezer mixed with, new experiments, but it always ends up sounding like something only Weezer could do. Crunchy guitars, emotional melodies, catchy but hopefully not cheesy, guitar solos.
We need more guitar solos. Well, there's not enough of them, if you ask me.
There's enough of them on our record. And in fact, the last song, we kept wanting to do more and more guitar solo in there, so it's me and Brian on guitar, of course, but then our bass player, our drummer actually picks up the guitar and joins us, and then our bass player got a double neck bass and guitar, so he can actually shred a solo with us, so there's five of us playing at once.
That's fantastic. Looking forward to that. So I think I last saw you guys playing the parking lot of the Woodfield Mall, and I was just blown away because it was hit after hit after hit after hit. Do you ever take time to stop and think, wow, I've really accomplished a lot?
I don't know. I guess this is what we always wanted, and this is what our fans want too, is to have a long-term relationship. There's so many bands that are amazing for a brief time, and you get all invested in them, and you make friends with other fans, and then for one reason or another, they just kind of fall apart. And we want to be in this, we've always wanted to be in this for life and go through changes with our fans together and see how we all grow. And it's great for them not only to be able to follow the same band for a long time, but also to be in the same community of fans and to be able to make friends all around the world and keep in touch with these people. And so, yeah, let's keep it going as long as we can.
Well, you've done a great job writing songs that have connected with many. So after the new record comes out, then what? Is there a tour behind this, or?
Well, what we're most excited for is we're doing a small club tour where we're playing the new album from beginning to end. And it's only like a month after the album comes out, so we can't imagine the album will have reached a very large audience at that point. So it'll just be small venues, the fans that bought the record the day it came out and they've already memorized it. And
awesome.
They're going to be there to sing along.
It's the best crowd.
It's going to be so fun.
Awesome. Rivers, I appreciate you taking the time to hang out with us.
Thank you.
Have a great show.
All right.
All right, man.
Take care.
Yep.